Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Ross Patterson Revolution! Brought to you by GhostBed.com!
It's because it's at 3 a.m. It's scheduled for 3 a.m., which is right when daddy gets going.
Sure.
Like that's my best time of life in this life. 11 p.m. to 5 a.m. is my favorite time in life. That's when I'm the happiest. That's where I'm like the most enjoyable of my day. A lot of people are morning people and they say, hey, man, I need breakfast. I love breakfast. I want to get up. I want to have a run. I want to do this shit at 5 a.m. I look at Mark Wahlberg's schedule and I want to stab myself with a very dull butter knife.
That one's extreme.
The Rock. I saw The Rock's schedule and I'm like, my God, man, I no prayer on this earth. Are you having fun? I want to look at The Rock and say, hey, man, just look me in the eyes. I know you're richer than Jesus and you're more famous than probably Jesus at this point, you know? Because I don't think Jesus is getting a lot of love these days as much as The Rock. If Jesus was alive, I doubt he'd have as many Instagram followers as The fucking Rock. Look that up. Look up The Rock's social media numbers.
Yeah, like, no, you're right.
More people follow The Rock than Jesus if Jesus were still here.
You're right.
But I bet if you looked him in the eyes and you said, hey, man, are you genuinely happy every day? Not one prayer.
And this is what I was thinking the other day. So people like Jennifer Lopez... Right?
Yep.
Look amazing. So rested and hydrated every single day. Jennifer Garner, people like this that look like that good, The Rock, they don't have the kind of fun that I consider like life fun. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
They're not eating food, staying up a little bit late, hanging out with friends, and letting loose.
No.
Right?
No.
So you have to choose. You have to choose between like looking great at a certain age and having people be like, oh my gosh, how do they do it? Or you have to have a good time.
Yep. And so speaking of that, the good time is around 3 a.m. Clearly, these guys are in on it. I'm in on it. I even saw a Kevin Hart interview too where they were like, what's he like? What's The Rock like working with him? Somebody like that every day. He goes, man, he takes a lot of naps, you know, and he's always late to set. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Was he joking?
No. And the reason why is to be The Rock and to do that every morning, you got to wake up at like fucking 4. He's got a team of people that feed him, all that shit. He's got to find somewhere in the day to sleep after working out and doing all of this shit to be The Rock. Kevin Hart's like, dude, I'm not even mad at it. He's like, I get it. And he goes, he's one of my best friends and I love it. But if you look at his schedule, where else do you sleep? Like... Master of cat naps. Here, the people at this Roswell event, these are my people. These are the people that I get
in
down
more
with.
Ways than one. These are your people.
In all of them, man. There are certain things that you read in life where you're like, fuck, man. Maybe they've got it figured all out. These 220,000 people do. Starting at 3 a.m. on this run outside of Area 51, to see them aliens, to grab them.
Right.
That's everything I want in this life. Aliens, late nights.
You think they're going to get one?
I think they're going to get one. And I think once they get in, right, hear me out on this, okay? Because you're not going to be tearing the arms and legs off the body at all. That's not going to be a thing.
That's crazy.
It's not like Gaddafi in Libya.
Sure.
Who got raped to death and then they tore apart his bodies in the streets. It's a real thing, and there's video footage of it. Definitely wouldn't recommend anyone at home looking that up. But with this alien, I think it's going to be more of a celebration of life and other life forms rather than I want to tear some arms and legs off. Right. So logistically looking at it, right? Area 51 is about 88 miles from Vegas.
Okay.
Perfect. That's almost too perfect.
It's like an hour and a half, an hour.
If that.
If
yeah.
That.
But speed limit's probably 80. You're going to kick that up to 88 to avoid the po-po.
Always.
We always do. Because they're not going to pull you over for going 8 miles an hour over, right? Boom. You're there in a fucking hour. So by the time they storm this, get the alien out of there, you're looking at 5. That's Dre's, baby. That place is just fucking opening, dude. That place is just fucking opening.
Can you imagine?
Yeah.
You're partying at Dre's.
I can. With the alien?
All these fucking dirty ass motherfuckers roll in.
Be great. Going in and celebrating another life form of this alien. Because you get him up on the dance floor. I want to see a hologram of Vici in the booth. Because I think you need him back for this. So we can start. The good thing is about these people, because usually people go about plans and fucking storming castles or streets or buildings or fucking white women protests of dumb shit on the beach. They go about it and they're like, oh, we need to do this now, like 24 hours, right? Not planned out enough. Shit doesn't really fucking work. Now these people, they're saying, hey, bro, take time off of work. Find a babysitter.
Sure.
Find...
Travel.
Travel, gloves, rubber, enough, like whatever you're going to carry the alien in, because they're going to pass that thing around. They're setting this up in advance as an event. This is, I'm going to dare to say this is our next Burning Man, right? You pull an alien body out of there, boom, strap it to the roof of the car.
Right.
Like an old station wagon, you know? Sit it upright. I don't know what kind of weight's going around in there. Guess it just what I've seen and speculated. I'm gonna say 70 pounds.
Mm-hmm.
I'm gonna say that alien's 70 pounds. Put a couple. You get a couple sticks, a couple boards lodged in on the back of it to keep it propped up. Mm-hmm. So that way, the alien, you could see it riding into Vegas, right? And then everybody is kind of following in this caravan along to Vegas. You pull in. Doesn't matter how rich or famous you are, or even if you're staying there, you can always valet your car. You can throw the keys anywhere to any hotel on the strip. Go to Dre's. Boom. Keys, you.
Mm-hmm.
Also going to need a box cutter to cut the ropes down from the alien body that was keeping it held to the top of the roof. VIP. If there was ever a case in this life to give VIP to someone or something, I would say it's whatever alien they dig up out of here. Last inanimate object. Or non-human, I think that's gotten VIP bottle service in Vegas, probably Air Bud. This is going to take more precedence over that, over the dog, and we're going to get the fucking alien there in Dre's. Now, if you haven't been, have you been there?
To Dre's?
Yeah, at 5 a.m. So last time I went, I don't know if your experience was anywhere near this.
Probably not. A
lot of Germans.
Completely different people. Yep.
Shirtless. A lot of shirtless Germans oiled up.
The
MDMA was pure.
Yeah, sure.
It was not stepped on. They did not put meth in there or anything else. Pure MDMA there. With an alien body above you on the dance floor with pure MDMA.
Mm-hmm.
Holy shit.
Right.
Next level. With Avicii spinning a hologram of Avicii. Not even spinning. Just tapping a key. Like tapping his computer.
Yeah.
This exact computer. He's tapping keys on his computer.
Yeah,
let's make it
realistic.
Let's make it realistic. Tapping on the keys of this computer in there.
Mm-hmm.
Whoa, sometimes I get a good feeling.
So uncomfortable right now.
And then you raise that alien up above your shoulders. Oh, my God, dude. We'll be right back.